Hello and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about streaming and vectored I/O in Postgres 17. This is an important step towards implementing asynchronous I/O in Postgres. Now, to be clear, in Postgres 17, we do not yet have asynchronous I/O, but we do see a performance benefit from what is essentially a refactoring work around internal APIs. And so today, I want to give you a little bit of a behind-the-scenes view on my understanding of the changes made in 17 and how they impact future asynchronous I/O work. Now, this commit by Thomas Munro, co-authored by Andres Freund, is introducing a vectored variant of an important internal API called ReadBuffer. Now, a buffer, or also it's sometimes called a page, is essentially a fundamentally unit in Postgres where Postgres is working with something. For example, it's doing a sequential read. It will read many, many buffers to read from your table sequentially. And so now this important internal API has a way to start a read and then wait for the result for one or more buffers instead of reading each one at a time. In the future, this will allow for actual asynchronous I/O to happen, but in the meantime, just the fact that the internal APIs are now refactored to work with multiple blocks at a time will already allow some performance optimization in certain cases. If you're interested in how this all fits together with asynchronous I/O, Andres Freund, who is one of the principal authors behind the asynchronous I/O work, did a talk at PGConf.EU where he talked about both the work that Thomas did in 17 to essentially introduce this important building block of the new ReadStream API, but also how this relates to all the other work that needs to happen to actually see asynchronous I/O in Postgres. Now, there's two main things that the streaming and vectored I/O work in 17 is doing. The first change here is to more systematically issue POSIX F-advisable need calls for random page access. This is, for example, needed when you're doing analyze calls and you're sampling a random portion of your table. And then the other thing is building larger vectored IOs by making larger IO requests. Now in 17, we have only a small subset of users of these new APIs. So this is mainly intended to start testing the waters, see some initial benefits, as there are three commits worth mentioning. First of all, Thomas added a simple example in PG Preworm. We also have this change authored by Nazir Bilal Yavuz, who added support for analyze to prefetch and read sample blocks using the new API. And this actually does improve analyze performance in my tests, sometimes about 10% performance improvement, just by being smarter about issuing POSIX F advice calls. The change where I think most people will see a direct performance improvement on their production workloads is to use streaming I/O for sequential reads. This was offered by Melanie Plagman, and the idea is that this now means sequential scans in Postgres will use the new APIs and will do larger reads. Now let's take a look at that in an example. So I have three virtual machines running here, one with 16, one with 17, and one with 17 without that streaming sequential scan patch just mentioned. And the motivation here is I want to isolate other performance improvements in 17 from just that individual addition of the stream reads API. Here on the first virtual machine, I'm just going to create a table with 10 million records. I'm going to do the same on the second one and the same on the third one, which is 17 without that patch. This table is about 346 megabytes. Now, this system here has a bunch of memory, so this definitely fits in the OS page cache, but it won't fit into shared buffers. So shared buffers here in this system is just the default of 128 megabytes. Also, if you're doing a sequential scan, it will use the ring buffer, and so it will not use all of shared buffers when you're just reading the whole table. Now, I just want to show you the performance difference here of running a select count star in this table. And I'm going to turn off parallel query here because I don't want this to interfere with the timing information. Now, here on 16, on the first run, we get 476 milliseconds. I'm going to do the same on 17. And so first run looks promising, but let's run this a few more times. And so here we can see the best out of three on 17 was 410 milliseconds. Now let's run a few more on 16 as well. And so on 16, we can see clearly there is about a 60, 70 millisecond difference between the two versions. Clearly in this case, 17 is faster for the sequential scan, noticeably. Now let's isolate the change here and let's see if this was just because of this patch. So I essentially used the latest development branch, I reverted Melanie's patch, and I looked at what kind of difference does that make. And so what we'll see here is performance is still noticeably faster on 17 with the patch than 17 without the patch. Now, one other thing we can do is we can run explain analyze. And the reason I like this is because it shows the performance difference actually a bit more explicitly. And explain analyze always adds a little bit of overhead, but you can see here that on this particular example, on 17, we take about 520 milliseconds. on 17 with the patch versus on 17 without the patch, we take about 575 milliseconds. So in an explain analyze measurement, there's about 50 millisecond difference between just that patch being applied. Additionally, sometimes there is actually performance overhead to doing small reads. So for example, here's a report from somebody on the Postgres performance mailing list where they saw an issue with the 8 kilobyte reads the Postgres does today in 16, where they were using a C-standard compressed BTRFS file system that does not do any I/O merging. And so it does a lot of effort for each individual I/O operation. And so now on 17, instead of the reads being 8 kilobytes reads by default, in this case, you'll get 128 kilobyte reads, but now you can actually use the new IO combined limit setting to change the size of the IOs. And so if you want larger IOs, because in your file system, that makes a difference, you can, for example, say IO combined limit 256 kilobytes, and then your read calls that Postgres issues to the OS will actually make 256K reads or less, depending on the operation. And so this, I think, already provides a nice benefit in 17. And I'm really excited, of course, about Postgres 18 and all the asynchronous IO work that we'll hopefully see there. But well done, Thomas, Melanie, Nazir, and everybody else who worked on this. I'm excited to see an important building block of the AI work land in 17. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.